This is the Australian Slouch Hat, or the Australian Bush Hat, or the Australian Military Hat, or the Khaki Hat, or the Digger's Hat, or the...
Created by Anthony Bezos in Australia.
There's a lot of names for the hat, and yet many don't know its history. Also, the history of it is a bit complicated, and yet it's an iconic symbol to Australian culture. So here's the condensed history of the Australian Slouch Hat, with a few notable bits, and a lot of mispronunciation. So let's begin with the context. First off, slouch hats are just hats slouched to one side. Slouch hats have been a thing since about the 17th century, but those were cavalier hats. The hats from the Austrian military in the early 19th century, called the Corsican hats, is said to be the inspiration for the slouch hat, but I don't see that's the case for the Australian hat at least. Clear resemblance show up in the late 19th century, and by then several militaries used a similar hat, but with different shapes and a different name. One example is the United States Cockshoe Hat, used during the Civil War and the Spanish-American War. They were more notable by the Rough Riders. But the country that inspired Australia to adopt the slouch hat was the British and India. I told you it was confusing. The British started using a new hat called the khaki hat, which is an umbrella term for a light brown hat. Khaki is a loan word from the Hindu or Persian language, meaning soiled colour. The word was used by the British India Army in the mid-19th century when the army introduced the khaki uniform and the colour looked like, well, the soil on the ground. And this was during a transitional period for the replacement of different uniforms in the British Army, though that's a story for another day. In the late 19th century, many Commonwealth countries, especially when they took part in the Boer Wars, used a khaki hat. Later, each nation adopted their own version of the hat. I'm looking at you, New Zealand and Canada. So who started the adoption of the hat in Australia? Well, it started by Lieutenant Colonel Tom Price. After his service in the British Army in Puma, Punjab, India, he took command of the new Victorian Mountain Rifles, taking inspiration from both the khaki hat and the Puma Native Police headgear. In 1885, the first Australian bush hat was adopted by the Victorian Mounted Rifles. Soon after, in 1890, the State Military Command had agreed that all the Australian forces, with the exception of the Artillery Corps, should wear a looped-up hat along with a pungari around the hat. Victoria and Tasmania chose to loop up theirs to the right side, while New South Wales, Queensland, South Australia, and Western Australia looped theirs on the left side. Why they loop up the hats? Well, it involved easy for drill movements and later parades. Then, in 1903, the slouch hat became the standard and formal headgear to almost all Australian forces due to the Defence Act of 1903. Then we come to the Great War, which cemented the slouch hat to becoming iconic to Australia's culture, from the Gallipoli campaign, the involvement of the AIF on the Western Front, and of course, propaganda. After the war, and especially after the Second World War, the Australian slouch hat had been recognised as part of Australian culture and a national symbol for Australia. There was even a fucking song about it. Now, let's get to some key variants. There have been a lot of changes to the hat over the years, not to mention the small changes some units make to their hats. So for time, I'll just talk about three main versions that are currently in use. The current hat is a felt wool khaki hat made by Akabra and a few other companies for the Australian Army, adding a 7-plaited pungari around the hat, 6 for the states and 1 for the territories, turned on the right side with a pinned medal of the Rising Sun badge inscribed with the Australian Army. On the front here is a badge or patch of which part of the Australian Army you are in, and there's quite a few. It's really a basic hat to cover from the sun and to keep your head warm. Well, perhaps a +1 in charisma and +10 in bartering. Next hat is the Emu Plump hat. This hat is worn by the Australian Armour Corps. It's like the standard troops hat, but with the added feathers from an emu. The hat style is traced back to the Queensland Mounted Infantry in 1891. Being slouch is kinda up to the soldiers, but I think they chose the practical option. And the next variant, we've gotta talk about the Sikh's Pungari turban. There are a few Sikhs serving in the Australian Army and wear the turban instead of the slouch hat. As you can see, the Pungari turban is a dark navy blue or brown khaki turban with the patch on the front. And really, that's just it. But I'll say this, it made for a great meme. Today, the slouch hat is still used by the Australian Army, and as long as this brown slouch hat with its side turned up, it will mean the world to be a symbol of Australia's nation, and the soldiers wearing it proudly for the world to see. Did I mention there was a song for the hat? Thank you for watching to the end of the video. Please like and subscribe. It brings a smile to my face. I don't know if I'm playing the Brown Starch Hat song in the background in case of copyright, but if you want to listen to it, I'll provide a link down in the description. And I've got nothing else to say, but stay safe, everyone. Sword to the hip, strike a victory.